So I can bring on our next performer. He is known as the mayor of Burlesque of New York City. See, I don't think you know, please welcome to the stage, Mr. Jonny Porkpie.
Ladies and gentlemen, what we've witnessed here tonight is a miracle. Underdog Jonny Porkpie has made it to the Burlesque Finals and shows every sign of being a serious contender.
All the more amazing because Burlesque is traditionally a woman's event, and Porkpie is not, in point of fact, a woman.
No, he is not. He is what you might call a man, and a somewhat flabby man at that. But he remains undaunted.
Oh, and here he is now, stepping onto the stripping field.
His costume choice, a male take on the classic burlesque outfit. No surprises there.
I was expecting a little more creativity from this competitor, but he knows the classic look goes over well with these judges. And the sock garters are a nice touch.
He's taking a confident position center stage, waiting for the music to begin. And there's the tune. Jonny Porkpie's burlesque number has begun.
Interesting musical choice, Howie. Sounds to me like The Stripper by David Rose.
Possibly the most overused song in all of burlesque. He might as well do some song from Gypsy.
True, but as a man doing burlesque, his use of music could be called ironic.
Well, let's hope that irony is not lost on these judges. Now what's he doing? It looks like he's getting ready to take something off. It might be. Yes, it is, I think. It's gonna be a glove, and here it comes.
On the downbeat tactic, capping it off with a sultry pull. Oh, and a lighthearted twirl! Saucy!
A very safe start to a routine like this one, but always a hit with the crowd. And here comes the other glove. Let's watch him work.
You've gotta love the way he threw that glove, Howie.
A masterful and seductive toss.
Now you just know he'll take that jacket off next. No other choice in an outfit like this. I'm betting with a sexy shoulder roll or... Yes, there it is. Yep. Wait a minute. What is this? He's not taking off the jacket. He is not taking off the jacket.
In a surprise play, Jonny Porkpie appears to be removing his boxers early in the routine. He follows it up with an underpants kick. Oh, he misses the catch. That will definitely cost him a point or two.
The midair panty grab is a difficult move, Howie, and he recovered quickly from the miss, so it might not go too badly against him. And now, here comes the jacket, just like I said, and the sexy shoulder roll I mentioned.
A move that just looks better when performed by a woman. But the song is coming to a close, and this athlete is still far from naked.
If this is indeed the end of his number, it's a 4-4 showing by Jonny Porkpie here tonight. And that was the last beat of the song. Jonny is standing perfectly still, and this crowd is just not sure how to react. But wait, listen to that. There's another tune coming in.
What Jonny Porkpie has done here is put two different songs together. Not a widely used burlesque technique in his hometown of New York City, but very popular in other parts of the world.
And the tune, the new burlesque standard. Fascinating choice.
Only time will tell whether it's the right one.
Now, what we're looking at here are some on-beat pelvic thrusts, a standard burlesque move, but one that serves in this case to remind us that the standard is not being upheld down there, if you know what I mean.
An unusual move with some unusual equipment, you might say.
By which you mean his penis.
Indeed I do. Wait a minute. What's this? In another surprise move from Jonny Porkpie, he appears to be dragging a chair out onto the stage.
Now, I've seen Jonny do chair work before, but only as part of a group number, when he could be considered the comic relief. To pull a chair out with no one else on stage is a bold, bold move for this young athlete.
To hell with firemen, screw the Red Cross. Athletes are the true American heroes.
And that chair is really going to give him a place to sit down. He's planning to take off those shoes. Like he is now.
This only helped me when I took my shoes off back in 72.
Now look at him unhook those garters. Of course, if Jonny was a woman, the garters would be higher up and attached to stockings. But in this case, they're old-fashioned men's sock garters.
Rarely seen on the leg of today's fashionable gentleman.
This is quite a nice trick. You've seen any number of beautiful women do it with a stock, but I can't say I've ever seen anyone do that with a sock.
You just don't get any sexy. Unless, of course, you're an attractive woman doing the exact same thing.
And he's up, and he's reaching for the top button of his shirt. Looks like he's setting up for a slow, seductive unbuttoning. But no! The shirt has been ripped open! The shirt is open!
Leaving the bow tie behind. Little Chippendales, but cute nonetheless.
He's gotta be thinking that this number is going well for him tonight,
Howie. And there's the tassel twirl. Never in the history of one lose has clutching his knee and appears to be in quite a bit of pain.
Possibly injury due to all that bouncing during the twirling. And I'm sorry to say, but this is it for Jonny Porkpie, folks. In a terrible tassel twirling twist, the man who appeared to have a win in his grasp has been shut down.
What a sad end to a brilliant career.